24. Bir marş nisa glasiya katnaşya bir ştadan Kanada'dan yurdunnel dünya koçetinnel bütün dünya ağlan etye inni Türkmenistanlılar ayaktan düşmeye inni biz Türkmenistanlılar talab oturur biz Türkmenistanlılar 28 yıl veri öz ecelerinden öz çağalarından ayrılan rejimi öz vatandan ayrılan devletin cinayetkarlarını in ayırmadan ben ayaktan düşmüyor. Şu an 28 yıl Türkmenistan'da kal olgun görmedi. 2 milyon Türkmenistanlılar taşır yurtunda yaşar. En her birinci iyon bütün dünya çağlar uğramak bunu. Biz şunun ait ya 2 milyon Türkmenistanlı öz çağlarının mehrum edildi. Öz çağlarını denlik vakti görmeden akla kucaklayıp bilen akla onlara geçici kömüklerini edipler. Şol sebepten Türkmenistan'ı ila oturan cinayetkarla dine Türkmen halkının karşısına bel katlayın cinayet. Şol çiğne biz bütün dünya cariyetçe, bütün dünya aitçe inni eğer siz hareket etmeseniz Türkmenistan'la ölçüştü. Biz öz elimiz veren ayrı. İnni bizim evimize hiç tak geçmiyor. Şolcu bütün Türkmenistanlıları, bütün dünya cemiyetçilerini, eğer yine de dünyanın bir çetinle, dünya hovtalayan bir yine bir ekstremist dönemeğine istoşnik dönemeğine istemeyen olsanız, onda bize koşuluşup, bizi kolla, ta biz dünyaya hovtalayan bir cinayetkardan dinleyelim. Ol hakiki cinayetkar, ol hakiki terörist. Şolcu gelin, hem Mehmet, bilelikte şunu ayrıyelim, şundan dinleyelim.
In English language, hello. Today we all came to here for the march of disagreement against the politics of Berdimuhamedov. How he made the politics a completely unfair people of Turkmen people. When the Lebap provinces hurricane strike, they didn't help nobody, even single family. But he was sending humanitarian help to other countries. He was sending to the Afghanistan, Russia, Uzbekistan, but he didn't help at all his own people. We're against it. We're also against the mass violation of human rights in Turkmenistan. When mothers have to leave their families, go to work in Turkey or other countries, they cannot come back to see their children. It's completely unfair. If they come, they wouldn't let them go. It's a violation of human rights. Every person have a free right to enter the country, including his own, and leave. But they don't give a dual citizenship.
What to say about the coronavirus situation in Turkmenistan? They preventing the fact that they exist. They even included like in this criminal code of Turkmenistan. If you saying something about coronavirus or even pronounce coronavirus word, they can you put you jail for that. They saying there is no coronavirus. It's total lie. Now Iran wants to open the border with Turkmenistan. If it's going to happen, it's going to be second wave of coronavirus, because Turkmenistan didn't do anything at all to cure these ill people. There happens cases of coronavirus, but government preventing. They saying it's a pneumonia or other than that, but not coronavirus. If they're gonna open the borders, it's gonna be a second wave, and all the countries that spent billions of dollars to prevent the spread of coronavirus, Turkmenistan didn't do anything. It's all is gonna be gone. All this money they spent is gonna be gone. It's gonna be a second wave. More people gonna die. So I also wanna add this situation about coronavirus.
Hi.
Also wanna add more details about hurricane. It happened on April 27, 2020. When it strike, there is some rumors, unproven facts, stating that over 400 people dead, and the government didn't help anybody. The children died, so many kids went missing. The government didn't do anything about it. They didn't help any single family. Even nowadays, there is no electricity, no water. They don't provide even food. All the hospitals are destroyed. People don't know where to take the medication. They living in unsanitary condition. And even the other provinces, Turkmen people who wants to help them, who wants to send them some help to this province, government stop it. They prevent people from doing that. They prevent own people to helping own people. Not disregarding the fact that government itself should help these people, they preventing other people to help this province, who is still suffering from the consequence of this hurricane strike. And I'm against it. I'm against the policy of Berdo Muhamedov. I also want to tell other countries, if you don't want to today these people rise and make a war in this Central Asia, they should support people. They should tell the Berdo Muhamedov to get out of the power, leave the country. We are against him, all the people. If they tomorrow he decides to hold the power with force, it's guaranteed going to be a civil war in Turkmenistan. It's going to be another Syria. So I'm also want to tell Trudeau and other countries, take a close action who you're dealing with. You should stop him. Stop now, otherwise it's going to be too late. It's going to happen civil war, it's going to be too late.